And welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I am the RPG chick. We're at Madhmr Bridge, looking around, exploring. I guess this is the bridge. Well, it's on the way to Defiance Bay anyway. So we killed two Xaurip Skirmishers so far, and they were a little bit tough, but certainly nothing we couldn't handle. So we continue.
No problem.
Continue our exploration. People. Lars Nilsson and Vanessa Smedley. We come in peace. Oh. And City Exa. Hello, Lars. I loved you. Oh, we can't. So say I loved your work with Metallica. We can't talk to them. We can only reach out for the soul. As you near, you feel a vibrant history contained in the essence of this man's soul. Voices from its past seem to call out to you. You see two figures, a human and an Omawa, standing in front of this man. The human just stands there, fuming, while the Omawa is yelling, red-faced with fury. He is leaning forward, a stream of profane imagery flying from his mouth, his face rapidly turning purple. The man stands straight in the face of the onslaught, unmoving, a bemused smile on his face. He holds a rapier nonchalantly by his portly flank, point down, but his hand is tightly gripping the handle, his knuckles white. The Omawa stops yelling, pausing only long enough to take a breath, intent on immediately starting again. The man holds up his left hand and begins to speak during the brief silence, trying to defuse the situation and cut off continued abuse. The Omawa makes a grunting noise and pokes the man on the breastbone to stop him from speaking, leaving the finger against his chest for emphasis. The man with the rapier tilts his head down, looking at the finger resting against his chest, then looks back at the Omawa without moving his head. The Omawa realizes too late that he just crossed the line. The man grabs his hand, squeezing and twisting it. There's a loud cracking noise, and the Omawa cries out. The man raises his rapier and punches the Omawa, using the handle as added heft. There is a second crack, and the Omawa collapses to the ground, unconscious, blood pouring from his nose. The second stranger looks up from his friend's limp body to see the tip of the rapier already pointed at him, a flat, unfriendly, and serious look on the face at the other end of it. He raises his hands in defeat and backs away, turning to run when he is far enough away to ensure he won't be caught. The man turns to leave, the smile slowly returning to his face. Kind of miss just talking to people, you know? What about Vanessa Smedley? You see a crowd doubled over, sharing bouts of laughter as a mischievous-eyed woman relates a tale of her last adventure involving an unusually self-conscious troll. She has them exactly where she wants them as she throws out the punchline, sending anyone who wasn't already smiling into tears of laughter. She curtsies at the crowd with a flourish and a wicked grin and makes her way to the bar, quickly followed by a legion of eager suitors, each trying to buy her affection with a drink. She turns each of them away, but none leave without a smile. She enjoys her drink, content, and starts to scribble down the beginnings of her next performance, laughing at her own jokes. Same. You see the interior of a small, dark shop. The shelves are covered with a variety of goods, some commonplace and others of a little more exotic variety. This man wanders the shelves of the shop, smiling and finally touching the items. He maneuvers through the aisles, the only person in the shop. He stops in front of a large display showing the model of a large worm, a plaque in front of it detailing information about its natural habitat, food preferences, and mating rituals. He moves on, wandering from display to display, stopping at each one to take it in. You almost didn't see that, and just, you know, your mind autocorrects. He looks out the window at the front of the shop and sees the sun has broken the building line. People are wandering the market, stopping into shops and loitering at the stalls, looking for a bargain. Standing before the front door, the man turns back to the shop and smiles again. He then unlocks the door and pushes it open, letting in the sounds of the market. All right, then.
Yeah.
And what does the flame reveal?
If we stand here long enough? I want to go back and see what's in there. But first, that's the bridge itself, obviously. Let's go clear out this fog of war here, see if there's any more skirmishers hiding about. Oh, there's a person. Damn looters, can't be bothered to find an honest wage. Years of saving just to see it all washed away. Paragund says, curse my luck. The woman mutters, kicking her foot into the ground and upturning a cloud of soil. As you approach, her ears twitch and she turns to greet you. Hail, traveler, she says with a half-hearted hand wave. The bridge to Defiance Bay is out. If that's where you're headed, you'll need to find another route. What destroyed the bridge? I figures we can't just go there. The river has been rising on account of all the storms. Here, where the river narrows, the flooding did the most damage. The Orlan woman folds her arms, a scowl overtaking her face. Guess they don't make things to last around here, do they? Out of the stone, columns collapsed in a flash flood, taking the whole middle section of the bridge out to sea. Excuse me. Madhmr Bridge was the most direct route from Gilded Vale to Defiance Bay. Merchants and travelers now have to find boat passage or add days of extra travel to loop around the bay. I guess we'll be doing a lot more exploring and fighting. So I started a ferry service, thinking I'd earn some coin and help others cross over to the bay. Peregrine shakes her head, her ears twitching as she speaks. And that was a bigger mistake than that time I allowed a cipher to court me. Mistake? How so? I had been attempting to turn a quick copper, but... She bites her lip, her face turning flush with anger. Just my luck. The blasted currents threw my ferry into the rocks, dashed it and my profits to pieces. Making matters worse, when I went to prowl the shore to salvage whatever crap shipping crates didn't sink, a pair of looters attacked me. She stomps her foot into the ground. The damn brigands had the nerve to attack. I managed to avoid harm, but now they have stolen by force all that is left of my fortune. She eyes you for a long second, her hand cupping her chin. You know, you look like you'd fare better against those looters than little old me. Could I enlist your help? We do need some money. How about we... Maybe she'll split some of the share with us. Give us a reward out of what we find. What's in it for me? You would make a good merchant, Peregrine blurts out with a laugh. I'd worry if you didn't inquire about your own profit motive. She scratches her ear, blushing as she speaks. I'm a bit destitute at the moment, but I have a shop over in Defiance Bay. If you help me recover my merchandise, I'll sell you whatever you want for a bargain. I will take a look. Peregrine smiles wide, her eyes pricking up. Thank you. I'm sure those thugs have made a mess of my stock, but maybe there's something there to be saved. How do I get to Defiance Bay, exactly? With the bridge destroyed, the best course of action would be following the river north. You'll be able to cross farther upstream, but you've got a long walk ahead of you. Goodbye. Follow the river north. Up here, you mean? And that's north. East. Do we want to go to Caenua? Or is this some hidden passage? No, it's definitely not north. Follow this river north. Okay. Yeah, that makes sense. I can say follow the river north. Thanks, we'll just take this stuff. Thank you. Deer cap? Oh, those are new. I can't remember all this stuff. We're finding a lot of new mushrooms here. This small, unassuming white mushroom is a common sight in the Deerwood. So it's our first encounter with one. Oh, might as well explore the rest. Again, it's a dead end, but might as well just see what's over this way.
I shall be discreet.
That's heat, her seeing us or not seeing us. Gyron's horn, I guess we'll call it. It's a little pocket in here. Any goodies? There's some down in there. But we obviously have to go around for that. But we'll get this. Like lavender. More of Admit's work.
Eh?
Eh? Eh, Sonny? Alright.
Keeping an eye out.
You do that. Another Xaurip Skirmisher. We love killing these guys. It's fun.
Eh?
Everyone back to melee. Try out your new axe, Firebrand. Amplified thrust off of our favorite target eater. Ally target, anyway. I don't want to waste his spells. Let's have him wait.
Eh?
Stuff here. What we got here? Oh, Adra. Do we have any Adra yet? An organic material crystalline in structure but shell-like in substance. So it's organic. That's funny. Adra can be found growing up through the ground in veins in many parts of Eora. Easy to carve and manipulate, it's a favorite of jewelers as a semi-precious stone and is often cut more intricately and beautifully than other gems. You know? If it's organic, does that mean it's alive? No spoilers, please, guys, on the whole thing. But, that's what it's saying, it's crystalline and organic.
Sure.
So an organic life form that's not carbon-based. Interesting. Maggots squirm amidst the deer's entrails. Yummy! Maggots on these? No. Will the maggots get to have fun on that one? That's where the party is. A troll. A regular troll. Not a forest troll. What's more dangerous? Forest troll or troll? We might just find out.
Hmm.
don't know, I'm skipping over people. Because I'm bored of switching back and forth. We need some kind of macro. There might be one. I have to check. You guys are probably sick of me doing this all the time. I'm not sure how tough this thing is, so let's get a couple buffs up. Okay.
Not to alarm.
Oh, it hit us hard. And I don't know what he was saying, actually. Okay. Barely injured. Alright, let's go with the necrotic thingy. Necrotic lance. What is he casting? I gotta remember to tell you guys what's going on. Armor of Faith. And, Aloth is still going. She still has to go with this amplified thrust, so.
How bad?
Injured, okay. Oh, now I can see the dots, okay. Again with the magic missiles this time. And if this can wade into the battle. Barbs of Condemnation? Sure, we'll try that.
How may I help? Ah!
You're currently attacking a foe with at least one defense that's much higher than the accuracy. Try to raise the attacker's accuracy or use an ability that targets a different defense. You know, where's our stats? Here. Oh wait. Okay. So someone's attacking something that's like 1 defense that is much higher than the accuracy of the character attacking it. Which would be who? Firebrand, I guess? Or Durance? Or Theodas? Or everyone? I don't know. Either way, it is damaged right now, so. Rather than cast a debuff, maybe I'll have him do that next time. He still has yet to cast this. I'll try a knockdown on this. Go with the necrotic again. And she's right up there with him, right? Okay.
What?
Didn't hit for much. We're on down to 2 dots though, and we're fine so far. He's engaged 2 of us in melee. Interrupted. Weapon ineffective for Theodas. That's what. its ear. This thing isn't, like, going. It's, like, so slow. Or it's missing. I saw it did miss a couple times and got interrupted. Works for me. So we'll lower its deflection with that. How about that?
Yes.
And we'll see if we stop getting this weapon an effective thing. Of course, it's almost dead now. And now it's dead. Joel skin. Blah. Should we rest now?
How may I help?
I think we're gonna forge on like this. And yes, you are watching episode 30, for sure. Okay. I'm gonna forge on.
And what does the flame reveal?
Nothing emerged, because we're just looking around and stuff. Plants. We'll just clear out this middle area, or not. Over there. Can we attack him from here, from range? Oh, hey, we get to level her up. Hey, hey. So points to advance, or we have points left 6, okay. So we can actually advance 1, 2, and 3. Stealth, lore, and mechanics, why not? Or do we want to be a jack of all trades, or do we want to be really good at one thing? Right now she's better at athletics and lore, and stealth. Let's go athletics and lore. Okay, we get to pick another one. Mental binding. Overwhelms the target's mental ability to communicate with its own body, paralyzing it. That's pretty cool. Paralyze versus will. This is just paralyze, or does it injure as well? Versus fortitude. It doesn't look like it injures at all. Phantom foes. Invades the minds of targets in the area of effect, causing them to believe they are surrounded by phantom foes, leaving them flanked for the duration. We also get another first level. Psycho-vampiric shield. The cipher uses the target's strength of mind against it, stealing a portion of its resolve in order to become better deflect incoming attacks. Okay. So we're taking away resolve and using it for deflection. Could have its use. Recall act. Oh, I want this, yeah. Causes the target to relive the psychic trauma of an injury moments after receiving it, experiencing the damage all over again. Foe target, 30% of all damage reapplied over 16 seconds. Versus will. Alright, we'll take that one. An antipathetic field creates a toxic physical manifestation of the mutual antipathy between the cipher and the enemy target. Anyone caught in the path between the two will suffer corrosive damage. Hmm. 11 to 22 corrode versus reflex. That one's pretty cool. Eye strike. Basically a blinding spell. Tenuous grasp. Basically a fear spell. I'm going to take antipathetic field. Our priest has some good, you know, debuffs. I don't think he has blind, but I know he has some kind of fear thing. Well, maybe I think it's to help us versus fear. But we'll go with this. Do you know I want that one too? Or it takes that away? Well, can we only take one? If we can only take one, go for that. I guess we can only take either one or two. Talents. Alright, we're gonna get into this stuff here. Biting Whip. What's a plus 20 damage? The Cypher Soul Whip bites deeper, granting a bonus to damage. Psychic Backlash. Invokes a retaliatory strike, stunning an enemy whenever they target a Cypher's will defense. Yeah, that's a very specific to a kind of attack. It's not really useful in a lot of circumstances. Draining Whip enhances the draining power of the Cypher Soul Whip, regenerating focus more quickly. Well, I actually like that one. To me, this is slightly more useful than the Biting Whip. And then we've got stuff like offensive, weapon focuses, which I should take at one point, and Venom Strike. Do I have to physically put... I guess we don't... I guess it just takes care of it for us. With a mixture of animal plant weapons applied to his or her weapon, the character is able to deliver a poisonous strike that does raw damage over time. That's pretty neat. That's pretty good. Basically 68 damage over 12 seconds versus fortitude. 3 per rest we'd get. Savage attack. Sacrifice accuracy for a boost in damage. I gotta read all this. Increases accuracy. Plus 5 accuracy against distant enemies. Good for starting off. Gunner. Reload speeds are faster for range weapons. Dangerous implement. To weapon Beast Slayer. Grants a damage bonus against all beasts plus 25%. Primal Bean. Damage against all primordials. These are all plus 25 damage for spirits. Vessels. I guess like those wicks things. Damage bonus against all wilder. Interrupting blows. Increases the chance to cause an interrupt with any attack. Plus 15% interrupt chance. Vulnerable attack. Characters slow down their melee attack speed to bypass a portion of their enemy's damage reduction. Penetrating Shot. Sacrifice attack speed for increased damage reduction. And Bloody Slaughter. All attacks at enemies with low endurance convert some hits to crits, and those crits do accidental damage. I like the way they write that. Convert the hits to crits. Yeah. Hold the line. Trains the character in new defensive strategies, increasing his or her engagement limit by 1. Plus 1 and get enemies engaged. Snakes, reflexes. Increase the reflex by plus 10. Bear's fortitude is plus 10 fortitude. Bull's will is plus 10 will. Cautious attack. The character attacks from defensive posture, taking care to never expose invulnerable openings. From this stance, characters receive a penalty to speed, but increase their deflection. Plus 10 deflection, minus 20 attack speed. Weapon and shield style. Equip shield's deflection bonuses are increased and grant an equal bonus to the character's reflex. And graceful retreat. A bonus to all defenses against disengagement attacks. Then we got utilities. I'm going to take a class for now. A class talent. Fast runner. Increasing movement rate. Granting defensive bonus against disengagement attacks. Deep pockets. Gain 2 additional quick slots. Ooh. That'd be really helpful, actually. That's why you see those ones locked. They're ghosted out. You can't put stuff in them. Arms bearer. Gain an additional weapon sat. Shot on the run. Recovery penalty while moving is reduced for ranged weapons. Siren of Flame increases burn damage and damage reduction. Heart of the Storm, shock. Spirit of Decay for corrode damage. Secrets of Rhyme, which is freeze damage. Quick Switch reduces the recovery time when switching weapons or spells in grimoires. That would be for our Aeloth. Wound Binding allows the healing of a modest amount of health on the user. And Field Triage allows the healing of a small amount of health on an ally. Friendly target plus 44 health. That'd be useful for someone to have. I'm going to take the focus gain, plus 33% focus gain. Draining Whip. Done. Awesome. Also, what about this little guy? Do you have time to try to attack him? Okay, my apologies. Actually ran out of disk space during that battle. It wasn't that hard. It was just two of them. And yeah, I didn't think we were able to move past here, but we were. Or we did. So stay tuned for the next episode. We'll explore the rest of Madhmr Bridge. However the hell you say it. Which isn't much. We'll clear out these little spaces here and then see what the hell's inside there. And then we'll see what we can do, what we can explore. See, oh, I can see the bridge is out. You know, so that might be interesting to see. So see you then, and endure. In enduring, I'll grow strong.